All right, so Instagram Reels has been out now for a few weeks, and the reach there, the organic reach, is absolutely, like, it's ridiculous right now. Now, touch more on that later in the video, because in today's video, I want to share with you three things that I have learned by posting, like, a whole lot on Instagram Reels for the last, you know, few weeks. And I hope that these tips might, you know, benefit you in your journey on Reels, you know? Now, I'm not gonna stop just there. I also wanna talk about, like, what Instagram Reels is, in case you, you know, you don't know and you've been living under a rock or something. And then we're gonna top it off with, you know, why I think you should, you know, be posting there. Anyways, I am not here to waste your time, so I'll leave timestamps so you can easily navigate to, you know, the position of the video that interests you the most. But I encourage you to watch the whole video, because there will be some nuggets of gold every now and then. I'm gonna jump there, put there, put there. Anyways, let's start the video. Yo, 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 Karla Fretta. My name is Arnaldur and I'm a photographer from Iceland. Now, first thing first, what is Instagram Reels? To put it just plainly, it's basically just Instagram copying TikTok. And that's, you know, that's it, you know? Now, with the Reels, you're allowed to put videos up to maximum of 15 seconds. And then it's shown, you know, in the Instagram Explore page and whatnot. And you can scroll and do that, you know, TikTok thingy. The thing is that TikTok has become too popular for the other apps. In Q1 of 2020, TikTok was the most downloaded app ever. So it's taking up a whole lot of attention. You know, these apps, the only thing that they have is attention. They want us to watch these apps as much as we possibly can and make us addicted to them, because that's how they, you know, make money, by selling ads. So when an app comes up and takes all the space, they have to do something, and Instagram made, you know, Instagram Reels. And it is indeed just, you know, a copy of TikTok, but it's not the same user experience really. And as I said, you can only have videos up to 15 seconds. Now we're going to touch more on why I think this is, like, super fun and very important that, you know, we use this. But if you know how to make, you know, TikToks, you know how to make Reels as well. Now, how do you get Instagram Reels, and how do you, you know, use it? Now, if you're not on there already, first thing you need to do is, like, update your Instagram. Once you've updated it, you can go to, like, the same place you go to Story, but down there you can now see Reels. So when you scroll through the Reels, you can basically, like, either create your own Reels there by, like, using your phone. I never do that, and I haven't done it with my TikTok nor Instagram Reels. I always make my, like, vertical videos with the camera, like I'm shooting on right now, then I edit them, and then I upload it to my phone, and then I upload that. There you can, you know, choose the music, put the text and all that, you know. TikTok, it's yeah, the TikTok thing, you know, but on Instagram. So it's pretty straightforward, you know, how you use it. You just, like, experiment a little bit and you will, you know, understand pretty quickly how to put text and all that. Anyways, over the last few weeks, I've been posting there regularly, and, you know, it's super nice how much reach you can get there at the moment. Like, I haven't seen this before with Instagram, but, you know, more on that in a second. First, you're gonna start with, you know, three things or three tips that I have, like, learned, and I'm now gonna share it with you so you can also grow. Like, it's like a growth thingy stuffy. I don't know, just three tips, okay? So tip number one is to actually put the Reels in your grid. Bear with me here. So the last thing before you upload, Instagram asks you, you know, do you want to put this in the grid? So you can say, like, no, and it's not gonna be shown in the grid, and it's only been gonna go, you know, on the Explore page. However, by putting it in the grid, your Reel will be shown on the feed to your followers, giving you that initial burst of likes and views, because your followers are gonna see it. And this is like on any social media platform, really. Like, depending on how, you know, your video performs, you know, the Instagram now is gonna show it to more people. So getting that, like, first burst of likes and views and, you know, reviews and all that stuff, it's gonna be, you know, shown to more people on the Explore page. And you can see now, really, that Instagram is, like, heavily pushing the Reels, because if you get on the Explore page, the first thing you see there is a big ass Reel, you know? But if you don't put it to the grid, and this has benefits, we'll touch on that in a second, you know? It's benefits to both of them. And I actually use, you know, both strategies. I'm going to talk about that. Wait a little bit, you know? Be patient. Patience is the key, really. Where were we now? Yes, we're talking about, you know, putting it in the grid to get those first, you know, likes from your followers. So Instagram is gonna, you know, be like, ah, this is a good video, and show it to more on the Explore page. However, if you're something like me and you want your grid to look nice, and you look at this and be like, this is ruining my grid, no problem. You can actually remove it from your grid afterwards. So what I often do with, like, good video, a good Reel that I want to put out, I'm like, oh, this is a, like, I want to put this on. I put it on the grid for only, like, 24 hours, and then I remove it. So it, like, gets shown to my people, or you guys that are following me. And then eventually, you know, it's gonna be pushed to more. And I definitely see, you know, the videos that I decide to put on the grid, they get more views than the ones that I don't want to. However, there is benefits to not putting it on the grid, and we talk about that in a second. That was tip number one. How about tip number two? Tip number two is to post often. Now, a little bit later, we'll talk about why I think it's so important, you know, to post often. But for now, just know that the organic reach there is like a lot. I have videos with almost like 70,000 views and I only have like 16,000 followers, which is like very, very, very nice. And this is not gonna be forever. So I want you guys and I want myself. You can do whatever you want, you know, but me, I want to post often there because I want to capitalize on this moment. Also, by posting more often, I get more, you know, overall views because I have more, you know, videos circling around in that, you know, explore page. Plus, and this goes really without saying, you know, I have a higher chance of getting a hit. Getting, you know, like a viral hit to get like tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of views. I haven't got that yet here. But I have a few videos that have like tens and tens of thousands of views. And that is made possible because I'm posting, you know, all the time. And the last thing I think is like important by posting a whole lot. I have a higher like possibility of finding like the style of video that works for me and is working for this platform. And once I hit that, then it's like a goldmine, like ding. I have like the recipe for success. Now I know like, okay, I can create more videos that are similar like this. Now you might be sitting there thinking like, hey, but if I post like a few times a day, you know, am I not gonna annoy my followers? Probably yes. And here it comes in that you don't have to put the videos in your grid. Which is, I think, is super nice, like not putting it there, because then you're just going to the explore page. So what I'm doing, I'm like doing a little bit of mix right now. When I have like a video that I think is like actually good and I haven't posted like a picture that day, I will put it to the grid. And this is like where my video is like, okay, this is a good video. I think it has potential. But other videos that I think are not like as good really, but I still, you know, want to post them, I like check not to the grid and then it just go to explore page. And here really in theory, you can post, you know, how many you want a day. You can post like, cause it's not been shown to your followers and it's not going on the feed. It's just on the explore page. So by having more there, you have a higher chance of, you know, hitting the big hit. Now, tip number three, I actually think is very important. This is to make sure that the cover, the thumbnail is good. I've noticed when I've had like videos that I think are personally good, but there is no good thumbnail there anywhere, it's not gonna get like as many views. Because when you are on the explore page, the first thing you see really is that thumbnail of somebody's, you know, reel. And that decides, you know, if I want to click on the video or not. If that looks interesting, I'm like, okay, I'll click on it. And he hooked me in. So I think the cover photo actually plays like a big role. And I want to like make sure that I find a good cover photo. And I might even, you know, add that in somewhere in the video that I'm like, okay, I want this to be a good cover photo. So I make a picture or whatever, trying to incorporate that so I know, you know, there's gonna be a nice cover photo here because that is, you know, that is the whole package and that's what's gonna get you, you know, views. And if you succeed there and the thumbnail is appealing, nice. Now, let's finish this video with a few words that I think are like super important. I encourage you to not to let this opportunity, you know, slip. This is the first time ever that I see some serious amount of organic reach on this platform. I've heard that like before 2000 something, there was good organic reach on Instagram, but since I started, which is like 4 years now, I have not seen that. But here on the reels, there is some serious amount of, you know, organic reach. And even for weeks, you know, I have reels that I put up like 3 weeks ago and they're still getting views. This, if you have put a photo up 48 hours later, it's like it's buried somewhere underneath. Nobody's gonna see it. But these reels are being, you know, shown to people long after you post them, which is super important. And I think this is not gonna be forever. This is a momentary, like right now. And I personally want to capitalize on that. And I highly encourage you to do that too. This is exactly what I did on TikTok over like a year ago now. I heard about this app and it was like insane amount of reach there. And I was like, okay, I was late to YouTube. I was late to Instagram. I am not gonna let this, you know, opportunity on this app that it seems to be getting a whole lot of attraction. Like, I'm not gonna let it slip through my hands. So I went on there and I posted like up to 4 videos a day for months, every single day. And first, you know, I didn't know what to do. And then eventually I found my style, you know, and I got a few viral hits. And today I have almost 600,000 followers there. Now, I don't know if Instagram really is gonna be like this, but I didn't know that about TikTok either. So like, it's like taking a chance and just seizing the moment really, because it is here right now. And this is a new thing. And like, people are like, a lot of people are like posting on reels right now. You do it for Thor and do it for Odin. Now you might be sitting there and being like, hey dude, these are all nice tips, but what type of content should I be posting? Now, to be honest, that is really something that I think that you have to figure out for yourself. What I post might be a little bit different from what you post. However, you know, I've noticed that either like something interesting, because you only have 15 seconds. So if you're making something interesting, that is like, whoa, this was pretty cool. That works pretty well. Also, if you have something really cool, I've seen like my friends, make like super cool drone shots from some super cool places with some nice music. That seems to work super, super nice. So then you have like interesting, cool, and also you know, funny. Like my cat videos, I have like a TikTok cat video where I was like talking to a cat and asking if I could take, you know, portraits, and the portraits were very good. And I like chopped it down like the cat was just following me, but really I was just bribing it with the, you know, cat candy. So that video is like funny and also has cool portraits. So that video also worked well, both on Instagram Reels, and worked very well on TikTok. But to be honest, I think it all comes down to, you know, what works for you, what style of video can you create that people like. And by posting a whole lot, like we talked about earlier in this video, you have a higher chance of, you know, finding what works for you and what you are able to create that people are interested in. And once you find that, then you really have the recipe for success, you know. Then it's just like hammer on that, and like success is gonna come your way. Anyways, I like think this is all. I'm not totally sure, even if I have like bullet points, like my mind goes like in turbulence all the time. So I'll edit something in. Anyways, if you have any questions, as always, feel free to ask in comments down below. If you, you know, could smack that like button for me, it really helps me out. Consider, you know, subscribing. I create bunch of videos, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. I'm out. Peace.